and welcome to Sarah's Stampery Retreat. Today we're going to be creating 5 shaker and aperture cards using this kit from the latest 2 Red Robins magazine box kit. So you can see in the kit you get this robin die with an outline die to go with it as well. You get this stencil, you get this stamp set with the kind of flora and pine cones and the robins. Then you get this paper pack. So you've got all sorts in here. You've got card fronts, you've got some gorgeous patterns, you've got your cut apart pieces. And then what I think is also really fun is that you get these pieces and you'll see that the die fits nicely around those. So you can actually die cut those out and you get 2 pages with 8 on each. So you get 16 of those to cut out already coloured. But obviously you can die cut this and colour it yourself as well. So then that's the middle. And I think mine's a bit mixed up, but you get 2 of each sheet. So then you also get these extra kind of, they're a little bit textured papers. So let's get on and make some cards. For my first card, I'm going to create a really simple aperture. So I've grabbed one of these card fronts from the paper pack and I'm just going to glue that onto a piece of green cardstock that's just slightly bigger than it, about 1/8 of an inch. And then I'm going to grab my scissors and I'm going to fussy cut this aperture. So I'm going to go through here. I find it easier to kind of cut a big hole out of the middle first so that I've got some room to move. And then you want some nice sharp craft scissors and I'm just going to fussy cut around the edge. So then I'm going to place this on my card front. So this is a UK A6 card front, so it's 4 1/8 by 5 7/8 inches. I'm just going to trace this through really lightly with a pencil. I don't really need all the bits and pieces, I just need a light version just so I know roughly where it's going to be, because then I can stamp my image and make sure it's going to show through the right place. So I'm going to grab my little robin from the stamp set and then I'm going to grab some black ink and I'm just going to stamp that there. So then I'm going to stamp it a second time on masking sheet. My one is the Gina K Masking Magic. And then I'm going to cut around this and I want to cut right on the line. So then I can peel the backing off and add my mask onto there. And then I'm going to grab my Stormy Sky Distress Oxide ink and I'm going to add that over the top. And we just need it to cover that whole aperture. And actually I was thinking I would have to rub out that pencil line, but the ink's completely covered it, you can't even see it anymore. So then I can take this off. And I like to store my masks on my stamp set, so I'll pop that there so that I know when I come to it again that I've got a mask for it. So I'm going to use my Altenew markers to colour them. So I'm going to use the oranges from the Tropical Garden set and the browns from the Water Garden set. And it's nice having so many robins in the paper pack as well, because it means you can kind of use them a little bit to get an idea of where to put your colours. And then I'm going to use the greys out of this Tropical Garden set as well. So I'm going to add some foam tape behind here. I'm going to add that on there. And then I'm going to cut this Merry Christmas from the pack. And then I'm going to glue it onto some cardboard just to give it a bit of stability. And see, it's just a scrap of white cardstock. And then I'm going to add a bit of foam tape under that as well. And I'm going to add that on there. And so then there's that first card finished. So then for my next card, I'm going to use the stencil. I'm going to use Eucalyptus and Forest Fern Fresh Dye Inks for the leaves. I'm going to do this wreath. And I'm going to use these detail brushes. They're these detail blending brushes from Ultenu to add it on, because I don't want to mask all these little bits. And so I just want a brush that will only go where I want it to. Some of these bits in the centres of the leaves are quite delicate. So in those cases, I'm just kind of using a bit more of a dabbing motion rather than kind of a round and round motion. Now I'm just going to add on a bit of extra texture with the forest fern. I'm just kind of dabbing that on at the base of the leaves. And then I'm going to use crimson and velvet with the very smallest brush to go through the berries. And then I'm going to use the velvet for this one to add a bit of shadow. So I'm going to lift this off. I think that's really pretty. You could leave that just like that, but I'm going to add some fine liner pen around the edges to add on some definition. Then I've gone around the whole of that wreath with the black pen, and I've also cut it out. And then I'm going to make a circular card. So I've got 2 6-inch red circles, and I'm going to place my stencil on it. Then I'm going to grab a bit of embossing reinker from my mixed media embossing brush, and I'm just going to pop a little bit on a block, and then I'm going to add a bit to my smoothie tool, and I just want to dab that through the sentiment. Then I'm going to add some of the opaque bright white super fine embossing powder from Wow. So we're going to create a shaker card using the wreath. So I've cut a piece of acetate that will fit nicely round my wreath. So I'm going to add some double-sided tape around the edges. I'm going to add that to the back. And then I'm going to add some foam strips around the edge. So I'm going to use these thinner ones today, because I'm not going to use anything that's got a lot of depth to it inside the shaker. And I'm adding them round. I'm making sure that when I start a new strip, it gets butted right up against the one before it, so we don't get any gaps for things to fall out of. So then I'm going to add some shaker pieces to it. I've got these Scarlet Smooth Disc Sequins from Spellbinders, and I've also got this Cosmic Shimmer Glitter Jewels. I'm just going to add some to the middle of my panel. So then I'm going to take the backing off my shaker foam. And then I'm going to add that onto here. And then we can shake that about. So then I just need to make the back of the card. So I'm going to grab the other red circle, and I'm going to put that in a 1/4 inch. And I'm going to cut off that piece. That will stop my card from rocking and rolling. Then I'm going to turn it round, and I'm going to score it at 1/2 inch parallel to this line here. So then I can add some glue above my line, and then I want to add on the front of the card. So then I've got my cool shaker card. So then for my third card, I've used my essential shaker dies to make a card front. So I've used the biggest one, the card blank, and I've done that by just making a normal card blank, then hanging the one side just slightly over here so that I don't cut the fold, and then it makes a nice shaped card blank. And then I've used the third biggest one to create a mat from white cardstock. I love my layering dies. I use them all the time. This shape is particularly good for card blanks because it's got a nice flat bottom while still being in an interesting shape. So then I'm going to use the pine cones from the set to create an all over print of pine cones on this piece. I was originally going to do it in black, but actually I think it'd be really nice embossed in gold, so I'm going to stamp them in embossing ink. And I always think it's easiest when you're doing this kind of background to start from the biggest and go to the smallest, because the smallest ones you can kind of fill in gaps with. And I'm actually just going to heat emboss the ones that I've already stamped before I go in with the smaller one, just to make sure that I'm not overlapping them. So I've got my polished gold super fine embossing powder from WOW. And then I'm going back in with the smallest one and just filling in some of those gaps. And then I can heat emboss those as well. And then we can colour them in. I'm just using the same brown pens as I used for the robin. So then we've got that coloured panel. So I'm going to glue that to the front of my card. And then where you've got the two dies here, I've used this smaller one, the detail one, to cut this from white cardstock, and then I've just coloured it. And now I'm going to use the biggest one, the one that's like an outline, to cut an aperture into our card front. Then I've got the aperture that can fit inside. And then I'm going to add some foam pads onto the back of there. And so then I can use the aperture just to see where I need to place that. And then when you open up the card, you've got a nice feature inside as well. So then I'm going to add some foam pads behind this. And I'm actually just adding it to the bottom of that, so because I want the top to overlap this and I don't want it to stick to there. So then that still opens, but it overlaps a little bit. And then I've got some of these small red gems, and I'm going to add those over the berries on the holly. And then there's that one finished. So then for this next card, I'm going to make another shaker. So I've got a 5x5 inch card blank. You'll notice there's a little mark down here. That's fine because that's going to get covered up. So I've cut a 4¾ inch square piece of this patterned cardstock. And the reason that I've cut it like this is so that the sentiment is in the middle. So I want to make sure that that's in the centre on my card. So then I've cut a 5 inch square piece of this green cardstock. And that's got a 3¼ inch aperture in it. And then I've used a 3½ and a 3¾ inch square to create this frame. So I'm just going to glue that on. So that's going to sit around my frame like that. So obviously this piece of the bird we want to cover up. So we're going to make sure that we do that in the next couple of steps. So I'm going to turn that over and I'm going to add some acetate to the back because we're going to make another shaker card. Because we've got a wider edge on this one, I'm going to add bigger pieces of foam tape. And again, I want to make sure that it's buttered right up against the next piece. And you'll notice I got fed up of running out of foam tape, so I got this absolutely huge roll from Altenew when it was on sale. So I think I'm going to go for red and gold in this one. So I'm going to use some of these red discs we used on the other shaker card. And then I'm going to use some gold glitter as well. And then I'm going to add on our frame. And this part where I've made a bit of a smudge with my glue, I'm going to put down this corner because I'm going to add something over there. And then we can shape that all around. And then I've got these poinsettia that I stamped and coloured and cut from the stamps there. I'm just going to add those across either corner, and you'll notice that this then hides that bit of robin that's still there. So I'm going to just trim off this bit a flower that's overhanging the bottom so that it stands up nicely. I'm going to leave this piece hanging over the top, but if you've got a tight envelope you want to fit it in, obviously you could trim that off as well. And then I might actually even just add a little bit of glue to the center of these flowers. And then just add on some of that same glitter that we used for the inside. So there's that card done. And it's got that lovely shaker element to it too. So then for my final card, I am going to use another UK A6 card blank, so 4 1/8 by 5 7/8 inches. And I'm going to add this stripy paper from the pack to the front of the card. So then I'm going to create an aperture with this die like I did in one of the previous cards. But I'm also going to use this from the paper pack. And I'm going to die cut it using this smaller die. So you can see it fits really nicely over that. You can just see a tiny bit around the edge to show you where to die cut. So you just make sure that that edge is even around the outside. And then you can pop that through your die cutting machine. So then you can see how beautifully that has die cut. So that will go in there. So then I'm going to glue this into the aperture. And then I'm just going to use these holly boughs that I've cut from the pack just to decorate the card. And then I'm going to cut out this winter wishes that I've added to some cardstock. And I'll add that on using some foam tape. I'm going to add that on across there. And then I'm going to trim all this excess off from around the outside. And so then there's that final card finished. So now we've got all of today's cards. I'd love to know which is your favourite. Please do let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed today's video, I'd really appreciate you clicking like below, and you can also press subscribe if you'd like to see future videos. If you press the bell button and select all, then YouTube will also notify you when I've got a new video available. All of the products that I've used for today's cards are listed in the description below. There's also a link there to my blog where you can find a pictures playlist if that helps you find what you're looking for. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope to see you again soon.